is, so there are in disaster what was happening previously is for any disaster just based on thumbs rule some relief was provided, but that relief was it was severely biased, means it would reach some people in, you can say, more than required quantities, whereas other people would be not getting any sort of aid. So this thing was there. It is even prevalent today in some you can say underprivileged locations or societies or some locations or some countries where, you know, adequate measures cannot be taken to ensure that in the disaster adequate relief is to all. But still, so what is done for that? Now there is a sphere project which we are going to discuss tomorrow in detail. Today what we'll see is we will see just the various agencies which are there globally which help mitigate the effects of disaster throughout the, you can say, globe, or and also in certain countries. Certain agencies work in certain locations only. That we are going to discuss. So this we already discussed in last week. So the various frameworks which are there, HIGO framework, Sendai framework, and all we have discussed. But still, just a recap for you all. So World Conferences on Disaster Risk Reduction is a series of United Nations conferences. So there are conferences which are held. Now generally these conferences they are held every 10 years generally. Of course there are three conferences which are there till now. So the first conference was convened. All three conferences have been convened in Japan, have been hosted in Japan. They have been convened by the United Nations. So first conference was there in Yokohama in 1994, and then we have the Kobe conference. And hence, based on that Kobe, based on that city, that Kobe framework was there, which we had studied the other day. And then we have this Sendai framework, which is going on, or which is the current framework, which is in practice. So the you can say the duration of this particular Sendai framework is from the 2015 to year 2013. So the United Nations Office for Disaster Risk Reduction. This is, you can say, the acronym for this is UNSDR. So you should remember. Of course, the acronyms, the letters do not match with the exact sentence. There are many acronyms which will be different from because they are carved in different languages. You should remember the United Nations Office for Disaster Risk Reduction, UNSDR, served as the coordinating body. So it served as the convener or the coordinating body for second and third UN conference on disaster risk reduction. So generally the first was just hosted by Japan, but the second and third, which was the HIGO framework and the Sendai framework. In Kobe, the HIGO framework was there, and in Sendai, the Sendai framework was, it came into existence. So it was hosted by the UN. So why these conferences are needed? Because they bring together government officials and other stakeholders, NGOs, civil society organizations, and local government and private sector. Because coordination is most important. If coordination is not there, what happens is, if disaster management is there, but it is again in piecemeal, it is not done throughout, or it is not done very efficiently, and all the affected persons may not be served well with the, can say, with the relief which is provided. Am I audible clearly now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So the third United Nations World Conferences adopted the Sendai framework for disaster risk reduction, which is the current framework which is on. Again, this framework, it was without taking into picture, because nobody had predicted that such a pandemic will be there. You know? There was previously also, if you see, there are various historical examples with us, like we had the bird flu, we had the swine flu, you know? We had the Ebola, you know? Zika virus and all. So these viruses were there before also. And what evidence was found in historical data that these viruses were seasonal, and the effects of these viruses was localized. They were not pandemics in that sense. They affected certain people also. Many people lost their lives also, but the highest casualty, I think it was for the Zika virus or the Ebola virus, I'm not sure, but around not more than 3,000 people lost their lives. So you can imagine, and this particular biological pandemic which is there, COVID-19, it has cost lives, you can say, many lives to the tune of 10 lakh or more than 10 lakh till now, and lost their lives. So you can imagine the the impact of this COVID-19, which is there. And hence, no such thing was predicted even at these conferences. People were, and hence why we have been taken off guard because of the various, you can say, the various lack of, you can say, such pandemic. Okay, of course, there was one particular case in 1918, which was there. We had the Spanish flu. But again, the Spanish flu was a one-off incident where people lost their life mainly because of their casual atropism. Of course, there were three peaks and all. If you study the historical data and all, you'll get to know. But such sort of disaster, it will strike in modern era was not thought of. Hence, various strategies were there, but still, this COVID has thrown all these strategies into, you can say, into turmoil. We were not well prepared for such kind of pandemic. Especially even the developed countries were caught off guard, like America, US and all, na, various states. They didn't think that this pandemic will create such an havoc. But it created a havoc, and hence you can say such sort of problems are there, na? Not only the problem on the medical front, but also on the, can say, also in the economic front, the various problems are there. So why we need disaster relief? So there is a 2014 data. Of course, every year the different type of data are collected, compiled. So according to the Center for Research on Epidemiology of Disasters, CRED is an agency which does some studies in disaster management. Disaster, you can say, type of disasters and all, different type of disasters, various affected areas and all. Historical study it does, and it compares with the current disasters. So what they found in 2014 was, or what benchmark were they, or you can say, what statistical data they found was, there were 337 catastrophes related to natural hazards. And almost 100 countries, 94 or 95 countries were severely affected by these catastrophes. Reported worldwide and has further increased since. Of course, the COVID-19 has not left any corner of the globe untouched. Almost every country is affected, except few countries where the population is, you can say, of course, if you see the African countries and all, except South Africa and this, you can say South Africa, apart from South Africa, if you see the African countries and also New Zealand and all such type of countries, the pandemic has not spread its route too much. Because why? The main reason was the international travel is not so frequent as it was in countries which is like country like US, or say even for that course for India. India also, Indian people also make a lot of, because of course the population is huge, and we take a lot of many, you can say, international flights and all these are there. So even if you say some cases were positive and the people came in contact and they came back, so many other people were affected. So this was the reason. Of course, developed countries are affected. This is a particular pandemic where developed countries are affected more than, you can say, underdeveloped countries. Developed and developing countries are, of course, the primarily affected countries are the developing countries. They are common to both. They are common to even the pandemics which are there in the developed countries, and we are in India, na? We are in between. So we are in this situation, we are in this dilemma, because we are not that too developed and also we are not underdeveloped. So of course we are affected from both spectrums. We are affected generally. So while this might seem like an enormous amount, the number of natural disasters are lowest of the decade. Of course, many natural disasters are there, but natural disasters, you can say, was the lowest of the decades. Of course, there are other compounding factors which have increased. Floods are most frequent, followed by earthquakes. The frequency and all these have decreased. The number of natural disasters has decreased. The frequency has increased. These events call for massive coordinated reaction within a short notice. This is because of sudden occurrence and disturbance in nature. This has increased, like tsunami and all, nobody had predicted before 2004 that it would cause such a havoc. In Japan, tsunami was there. Tsunami is a frequent phenomenon. But it will cause loss to life and property. Life would be lost to the tune of, you can say, more than 2 lakh people. That was not envisaged. That was not thought of before. So these things are there. So every, you can say, disaster teaches some new things. that's where our disaster relief organizations come in. So what we need to do is our disaster management agencies need to upgrade themselves. What will happen is if they do not upgrade themselves, again if they follow the normal, you can say, historical methods of providing disaster relief and disaster mitigation, again in the advent of some such disasters like this pandemic and all, again there will be some problem. They often operate together with and sometimes next to local governments and the military. So now on we are discussing the various organizations which are there, prime organizations which are there at the global level which work towards the disaster management. So you can expect a question on this, how the international agencies or international relief agencies help in disaster management. Of course, now we have shifted globally also, and in India also, there is a paradigm shift from, say, relief-centric approach to a more of a preparatory approach. Of course, the United Nations also has thought in 1919 that it will go for disaster risk reduction rather than spending money or you can say reacting to a particular disaster on relief and all. What UN was thought that we will prepare or we will build the communities themselves, we will, you can say, compatibility will build in such a manner that in the advent of any disaster, what will happen is the loss of lives are minimum. So previously only it is said prevention is better than cure. Same things are there to be followed in disaster management. So United Nations Office for Disaster Risk Reduction, UNSDR, what they did was their office brought some strategies which we'll discuss in due course of time. So this United Nations Office, UNSDR, was created in 1999 December. It was established to ensure the implementation of international strategy for disaster reduction. So they passed a General Assembly resolution so that globally also all the signatories, they will not be bound to follow, but they should at least develop a framework in their respective countries to develop a international strategy for disaster risk reduction. Like in India, we have the National Disaster Management Act and National Disaster Management Policies. And based on that act and with their policies, we have created NDMA, then we have SDMA, DDMS, and we have then again local government bodies, panchayat organizations. These all things are there. Likewise, every other country who is a signatory of this accord, what they were supposed to build their various, you can say, strategies for disaster risk reduction in their countries. Functions span the social, economic, environmental as well as imminent real fields. When we will discuss the SPHERE project, it will be more clear how to do all these various, how to touch various parameters and all this will be discussed. So the current framework, which is the Sendai framework, is a 15-year voluntary. Voluntary means what? The companies are not binding to follow it. Sorry, the countries are not binding to follow it. It is their choice. So it is a voluntary. Voluntary means, voluntarily, like some, you can say, by their own choice, non-binding. There's a non-binding agreement that maps out a broad, people-centered approach to disasters. This word is important, people-centered approach. Because if we do not involve the communities, what will happen? The disaster management, no matter how hard they strive, they will not, because people's role is most important. People should be told, because the golden hour is most important. If the golden hour, in the golden hour, the disaster is not tackled properly, or the you can say the proper measures are not taken, what will happen? People may lose their lives. And also before the disaster, also before the disaster strikes, also people should ensure, the community should ensure that they have a robust framework so that in the advent of any disaster, they are not affected. Like in Mumbai also, if you see the Mitti River project, various mitigation measures are taken. It is not, you can say, 100% robust. That is a matter of fact. That is there. That is the fact of the matter, that the this Mitti River project, expansion project and all, that is not, it is done on ground. It is also on paper also, various studies of were done. But still people are affected due to floods, and even the impact has been reduced. Previously many people lost their lives, many attempts and all these are there on the banks of that Mitti River. Their casualty figure has gone down, but again, of course, because there are many other things, like people, the municipality and all these work, they do their works properly also, they may be doing, but what happens is many people, human activities, industrialization and all, they just soak up the gutters and all these things, all the you can say all the projects and all the other the projects, the construction projects and all different type of projects which are taken up, they throw the debris in the river and the river again gets soaked up. So this thing, it needs continuous monitoring. Likewise, various other risk reduction measures can be taken, like for landslide management also certain risk reductions can be taken, na? Like if you see if you have anybody of you may have traveled through the Lonavala Ghats or even in the Konkan Railway, if anybody has traveled, many of you may have traveled, na, if you go towards south and all. So if you see, there are various, you know, previously in the initial, in Konkan Railway case, I will tell you, initially many accidents or some accidents were there because boulders used to come down on the tracks, and then trains, they were just the accident, they would just meet the accidents, or even in tunnels and all, na, these boulders would come on in the tunnels and then their accidents is there. But now what they are doing, they are monitoring, they are after two or three trains pass, they again check for the entire stretch. They have various bogies and all these sort of mechanical equipments and all to check whether the alignment and all these things are proper. That is done. Plus they have done some, you can say, gunniting and all of these, all the boulders, and also they have made some rock meshes and all, na? So this system is there where this, this is reduced. So you can see, we learn from experience, you know, experience makes us, you know, we learn from experience, and then the disaster, how to tackle the disaster, the effects are. So far in Mumbai also, na, previously if you see 10 years back or 15 years back, many landslides were there, but now if you see the intensity of landslides and all this, it is, of course, the buildings are collapsing, old building deliberate structures are collapsing. Because why? Because people are adamant, people are not ready to move out of the dwellings, because they cite that they do not have adequate resources to move to, or they do not have sufficient funds. Many other things are there, but still it is a dangerous situation to be living in. Many buildings in Mumbai today also, they are, you can say, severely under disaster, higher disaster risk. Am I audible clearly?
Yes.
Fine. So what the Sendai framework, what it set out four priorities. Understanding disaster risk is important. What is the exact disaster risk? This should be understood. Strengthening disaster risk governance, investing in disaster risk reduction. This is the prime, you can say, area where countries, they do not focus on, because what they think, इनको एक ऐसा बोलना होता है कि जो अभी तक नहीं हुआ आगे क्यों होगा. That is the thing, ना, ये बिल्डिंग 100 साल से खड़ी अभी तक नहीं गिरी, आगे क्यों गिरेगी. This is a common phrase which you may have, है ना, when you meet local people and all, ना, they coin such phrases, but it is not true, है ना. 100 साल तक नहीं गिरी, बट उसका यूजफुल लाइफ, उसका सब खत्म हो गया, तो इट मे कोलैप्स एट एनी पीरियड ऑफ टाइम, है ना. यू मे हैव लर्नड एंड यू मे हैव हर्ड इन न्यूज़ एंड ऑल, ना, मेनी प्रीवियस, यू कैन से, और मेनी ब्रिजेस इन मुंबई, दे हैड सम 2 इयर्स बैक और 3 इयर्स बैक, दे हैड डेमोलिश. आफ्टर दैट दैट बिल्ड पर्टिकुलर ब्रिज दैट फेल, ना, ऑन द रेलवे आरओबी व्हिच फेल. आफ्टर दैट मेनी प्रोजेक्ट्स वेयर टेकन, इवन इन वीटी दैट आरओबी रोड ओवर ब्रिज फेल. There are many audits were done and many bridges were taken down and new bridges were built. So understanding, investing in disaster risk reduction, investing is important, because if you do not invest, what will happen is after disaster, you try for, you can say, compensating in all the impacts of disaster, it will lead to more loss, and so you can say if the useful life of the project is over, it should be shelved and new project should be taken. So enhancing disaster preparedness, this is also important. I will give you an example, a simple example, na? In case of some, you have a vehicle, na? Vehicle, if you are having, and that vehicle has become very old, so its mileage which was there, which was 10 kilometers per hour, now it is giving mileage of 5 kilometers per hour. So it has reduced. So what you think of, why should I invest new, and I do not have enough resources, enough money to purchase new, you can say, vehicle. So what you do is you go on continuing with the same vehicle for, say, some more 3 to 4 years. So what happens in due course of time, if you are a regular traveler, and what will happen, every day cost of petrol, if you see, you will be spending almost 100 to 200 rupees more than what you are spending on your new vehicle. So if you compare, in 3 to 4 years, if you see, the cost of the vehicle, which was, you know, or you can say the investment which you have done in a new vehicle. If you see, almost 2 to 3 lakhs rupees you may have invested in the extra petrol amount which will be required. In that sense, you know, in disaster management also it can be treated, because what people do, they think, you know, even governments, even various governments and all, or even local bodies and all, urban local bodies, what they think that, okay, we will manage this disaster, we will not take precautions. Or in case of rains also, in case of floods, that flood can be managed even if this intensity of rain is there. But if the previously, if you had done sufficient measures, if you had cleaned the drainage and all, if they had done, if you had spent some more money, maybe the impact of disaster would have been less. Like the Mumbai floods, which are there of 2005, it caused a tremendous loss to property. Almost 6 billion rupees were lost. No? So you can see, you can just imagine the impact of the disaster, how it is there, and if mitigation measures and all will be taken. I'm not saying that entire fund, which the entire loss would have been minimized, but at least some money would have been saved. So likewise, we have this UNESDR, which has it led by United Nations Special Representative of the Secretariat General for Disaster Reduction, and it has over 100 staff located in headquarters in Geneva, in Switzerland. It has five regional offices in various parts of the various continents. Like in Africa, we have in Nairobi. In America, we have the Panama City. America means it covers both North and South America. Africa and Nairobi is in Kenya. Arab states, we have Cairo in Egypt. Asia Pacific, we have Bangkok. And in Europe, we have Brussels. UNESDR coordinates international efforts in disaster risk reduction and guides, monitor, as well as report regularly on the progress of implementation of the Sendai framework. So it monitors, it sees whether a country is applying or it is strategically making some measures to be prepared for disaster or reducing the impact of disaster risk or not. Global Assessment Report on Disaster Risk Reduction is an authoritative biennial, means after every 2 years. Analysis of global disasters, risks and trends. So it, after every 2 years, it publishes a document of disaster risk and how countries are taking measures to reduce. So there is International Strategy for Disaster Risk Reduction, ISDR. So it is the strategy of UNESDR. So it is created in December 1999. UNESDR is the secretariat of the International Strategy for Disaster Risk Reduction. Its core areas of work include ensuring disaster risk reduction. It is applied to climate change adaptation, increasing investment for disaster risk reduction. If you see, generally the developing countries, they are spending 2% of their GDPs in disaster. But if the disaster risk itself is reduced, maybe much more money can be saved. Building disaster resilient cities, schools, hospitals, strengthening the international system for disaster risk. So these all strategies are there, which are implemented by UNESDR, and they are monitored. So there are various organizations pertaining to United Nations, which is the global body for disaster and other, we can say, crisis management. So the Office for Coordination of Humanitarian Affairs, that is OCHA, is in collaboration with the Interagency Standing Committee, IASC, is the arm of the United Nations, responsible for bringing together national and international humanitarian providers to ensure a coherent response to emergencies. So what it does, it ensures that wherever the disaster is there, some resources are there, and that those resources are immediately supplied. Like in India, you can say India has achieved self-sufficiency in dealing with disasters. But many other countries are there, many other countries, if you see in the African continent, many other countries are there which are not well versed to deal with disasters because of poverty, because of many other reasons. In India, luckily economically we may not be that rich, but technologically and all, India is a sufficiently well advanced country. So they ensure that the coherent response, that every person affected, we have to save all. The previously the logo was save maximum people, now the logo is save all people. This is important. Food and Agricultural Organizations of the UN, so FAO, provides early warning of impending food crisis and assesses global food supply problems. Many countries are there. Like in India also, you may have read a report of rising onion prices. If you see the onion prices today in Indian market, it is 80 to 90 rupees, somewhat more or less like that. ना, व्हाई इट हैज हैपेंड बिकॉज़ ऑफ द सडन रेन व्हिच वर ऑब्जर्वड इन द ओनियन प्रोड्यूसिंग डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स है ना, स्पेशली इन इन महाराष्ट्र वेयर द ओनियन इज प्रोड्यूस्ड. एनीबॉडी कैन टेल? यस, एनीबॉडी? महाराष्ट्र में ओनियन वेयर इट इज प्रोड्यूस्ड?
सॉरी सर,
वेयर ओनियन इज प्रोड्यूस्ड इन महाराष्ट्र प्राइमरीली?
इन नाशिक सर, आई थिंक.
नाशिक, वेरी नाइस, गुड. दैट मींस यू रीड न्यूज. So generally Nasik and the surrounding places, na, like Lasalgarh and all these places are there. Many small, you can say, cities or towns are there, which are onion producing centers. Na, so what happened na, due to this sudden onset of rain? Previously, if you see 2 weeks back, the onion prices were very low, 20 rupees per kg or 25 rupees per kg in the market. But now they have suddenly increased to say 90 rupees kg. So why this has happened? Because of we are lacking domestic supply. Domestic supply is not there. We are dependent on domestic supply. There the population of India is too used to be, you know, to be filled with the limited sources of supply, you know. If that those districts are affected, of course the demand is more but the supply is less. If the supply is less, what will happen is the prices will escalate, na. Kam paise mein agar, sorry, kam cheez hai aur zyada logo ko chahiye to zyada paisa jo dega usko वो चीज पहले मिलेगी. इट्स अ सिंपल लॉजिक, है ना. सो द प्राइसेस आर एस्केलेटेड सो दैट एटलीस्ट पहली चीज तो उनका जो लॉस है वो रिकवर हो जाएगा. दूसरी चीज क्या है, दोज हु रियली नीड इट और पीपल विल स्पेंड लेस, ना. जो लोग पहले दो केजी कांदा खरीदते थे वो अभी आधा किलो एक केजी लेंगे. अरे अंडरस्टैंडिंग. सो दीज आर थिंग्स आर देयर. सो व्हाट यूएन डज इन दैट, ना. सो यूनाइटेड नेशंस फॉर एग्रीकल्चर, यूनाइटेड नेशंस आर्म इज देयर फूड एंड एग्रीकल्चर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. इट इंश्योर्स दैट especially where the severe food crisis is there, na? There is no food grains and all, some like in places like Sudan and all, na? These countries are there. But there's a very
You are not audible, sir.
You can imagine 1.5 years almost without rain, which ensures, na, because there are many war-torn countries in the, especially the Syria and Libya. These all countries are there in that particular regions, na, towards. So there are many war-torn nations which are there, and people are now fleeing. They are now fleeing their homes and they are going to the European countries. So of course. These countries should adapt and should accept them, you know. These all things should be there. So international arrangement of migration is also there, which helps to transfer refugees. Refugees should be, every country cooperates, especially the developed countries should cooperate in taking some refugees for some duration of time, you know, till their country comes back to normalcy. And all these things are again they are monitored and all by UN. Office of United Nations High Commissioner for Human Rights. So human rights provides assistance and advice to governments and other actors on human rights issues, sets standards and monitors rights violation and all these things are there. United Nations, you may have heard about this, na, especially in your school days also you may have heard about UNICEF, na, in civics especially. So United Nations Children's Emergency Fund, UNICEF, upholds children's rights, survival, development and protection by intervening in health, education, water, sanitation, hygiene and protection. If you see, na, passport holders may know this. I'm not sure about others, but passport in passports, what is there, na? If you have done your 10th standard, na, generally it is done to क्यों करते हैं ताकि लोग जो है ना, people they do not है ना, जैसे human trading जो करते हैं ना, those are involved in flesh trading and all, है ना. What they do generally, छोटे बच्चों को क्या करते हैं, they send to other countries where and these things on all these are followed. So what the this has done is the passport requires that you should have emergency immigration required stamp to be attached. So you will not be sent without, if you do not have this immigration not required stamp, you should have immigration required, and so if you produce during your passport, if you produce your 10th standard certificate, एसएससी का आप सर्टिफिकेट अगर आप प्रोड्यूस करते हो, स्पेशली दोज हैव गिवन हु दोज हैव अप्लाइड फॉर पासपोर्ट्स एंड यू हैव गॉटन द पासपोर्ट्स, वी नो दिस. सो दो इफ यू प्रोवाइड योर 10 स्टैंडर्ड पासपोर्ट, व्हाट इज रिटन इन योर पासपोर्ट, इमिग्रेशन नॉट रिक्वायर्ड, दिस स्टैंप इज देयर इन योर पासपोर्ट. Otherwise, what happens if you do not produce this immigration not required, this stamp will be mentioned, and then what will happen, more care will be taken for people who are having the passports on which immigration not required, immigration required is there, or at least immigration not required, this stamp is not there, the more airport authorities and all will take more care before, you know, processing the visas and all of these people, or even sending them or making them board the flights. And there is World Food Program is the principal supplier of relief food aid, and especially in war-torn countries or flood-affected countries. World Health Organization provides global public health leadership by setting standards, monitoring health trends, providing directions on emergency health issues. And this one more international, important you can say agency is there. That is the International Committee of Red Cross. International Committee of Red Cross. So this is a committee which has its roots based in Swiss. So it is a Swiss-based humanitarian organization and founding members of International Red Cross and Red Crescent Movement. In India also we have our Red Cross India, and also we have Red R, which is there in Pune. Its headquarters is in Pune. Red R Society is there. So it takes very good, you can say, trainings and all for disaster management professionals. Very good. If you, anybody of you is thinking of doing pursuing a career in disaster management, it's a very noble field, and you can take various trainings which are provided by these Red R people. If you are certified Red R, you can say disaster management professional. Of course, you can apply for various. You can say these all organizations, and of course, you can help the people who are suffering in various. Parts of the globe, we can help to alleviate their sufferings. So, this agency is there, International Committee of Red Cross. So, this society is there. So, they have two movements, Red Cross, Red Crescent Movement, and the Red Cross Movement. So, what they do is they have set standards, you know? They have set standards and policies for disaster management. So, International Federation of Red Cross and Red Crescent Society is the world's largest humanitarian organization. Made up of 186 member Red Cross. India is a signatory of Red Cross, that is, we are a member of this Red Cross, and Red Crescent Societies provides physical rehabilitation to people injured by explosive weapons or other type of incidents. ISCRC, that is International Conference of Red Cross and Red Crescent, in collaboration with WHO, the health emergencies in large populations help course is there. They provide a health course to upgrade professionalism and humanitarian assistance program. What previously was done was just based on thumbs rule, people were helped. But now, professionally, they are helped. Na? What people, you know, like, जैसे ना पहले लोग कैसे दवाई कैसे देते थे, सबको सेम दवाई दी जाती थी ना, कुछ भी सर्दी हुई, सबको सर्दी का डोज दे दिया, डॉक्टर्स का काम खत्म, ऐसा होता था. But now, different, सर्दी के भी different types है ना, flu के भी various types of flu are there. So, in case of disaster also, people may be affected in different levels. Eh? So, you cannot have common policy for all. You cannot have common thing for all. Different people should be helped in different ways. Eh? Some people may not be linguistically understand the various, you can say, linguistic barrier may be there. There may be different other type of barriers. Eh? Social barriers may be there. Some people may be treated untouchables in certain sections of the society. And some tribals may be there, you may need to help these tribals. So such things are there. What happened in the tsunami in Andaman and Nicobar, many tribals could not be saved because again they were cut off from the mainstream. You know? So these things were there, these things that should be studied, or these things should be, various courses are there which need to be undertaken so that exact measures are there. Like some studies are there, sometimes what is there, water is not there. So you can provide water, you can supply water for some days, but you need to have identify some sources of water for the people. So what you need to do is you need to provide some more borewells and all, no? Some temporary borewells and all. So you should be, you should use your engineering mind, or you should use your engineering knowledge, scientific knowledge. You should understand that the water depth in this particular area will be so and so. ना उसके फिर बोर डेप डेटा एंड ऑल ये सब आपको निकालना पड़ेगा, समझना पड़ेगा. कॉमन पीपल विल नॉट अंडरस्टैंड दिस. ये सारे कोर्सेज है, हाउ टू हेल्प, व्हाट मेजर शुड बी टेकन, ये सारे कोर्सेज करते हैं प्रोफेशनली करते हैं. व्हेन वी विल स्टडी दिस स्फीयर प्रोजेक्ट मे बी समथिंग विल बी क्लियर इन इट. इन्वॉल्वमेंट ऑफ इंडिविजुअल और फिजिकल थेरेपी इंस्टीट्यूशन इन सपोर्टिंग दिस डेवलपमेंट. So again, the ILC publication, Healthcare in Danger, the responsibilities of healthcare personnel working in armed conflicts, है ना, बहुत सारे लोग है ना, especially in armed conflicts where two neighboring countries are fighting each other. So what happens? इसमें भी Red Cross and Red Crescent Society they have their workers which go and help these people, because again many people are affected, है ना, and normal working is it is thrown out of gear. So what is done? These agencies they should with them maintaining their own है ना protection, protecting themselves also. ऐसा नहीं है कि लोगों को बचाने बचाने जा रहे हो और वो खुद है ना दुश्मन के इसका शिकार हो रहे हैं, ऐसा भी नहीं होना चाहिए ना. Of course the country or the hostility between two countries will be there, है ना, ऐसा it is going to be there, है ना, because very various reasons are there. But at the same time the relief should be reaching the people as well as you yourself should not be at stake. You should not be in danger. So healthcare in danger, how to save yourself, how to work in bunkers and all, how to make temporary, ये सारी चीज़ें उनको सिखाई जाती हैं. International Federation mission to improve lives of vulnerable people by mobilizing the power of humanity. So it combines relief activities with development works. ऐसा ही नहीं है कि सिर्फ relief दे दिया काम करना, ऐसा नहीं. It will give some development activity, it will some sort of employment will be given so that they can generate revenue. IFRC acts as the official representative of the member society in the international field. So World Organization for Animal Health. So iska pehle naam ye tha, Office Internationally des Epizoots, hai na. So zoonosis generally means the transmissible diseases which are there from animals to human beings. So that means zoonosis, hai na. So animals mein bahut sari bimari hote hain aur abhi bhi hai. ह्यूमन बींग्स में नहीं है. मैनी एनिमल्स आर मैनी मैनी दे हैव मैनी डिजीजेस, है ना, एंड सम डिजीजेस आर देम विच आर स्प्रेड अमंग दे आर हर्ड्स और दे आर पर्टिकुलर यू कैन से दे आर कम्युनिटी ओनली, एनिमल कम्युनिटी ओनली, और सर्टेन डिजीज आर स्प्रेड इवन टू द ह्यूमन बींग्स. लाइक दिस कोरोना वायरस इट इज टोल्ड टू बी सेट फ्रॉम बैट्स, है ना, दिस थिंग्स इज देयर. So it spreads from human to how to control the zoonosis, that is important. So World Health Organization for Animal Health, not only preserving and maintaining the health of animals but also the spread of diseases from animals to human beings is avoided. Evaluation of performance of veterinary services, this is their OI previously, there is a framework I'll share in the group, you can just read, go through the framework. PAS gap analysis, legislation, missions and other support via PAS pathway in order to strengthen veterinary support, these all things are there. So this office and office for animal health, hai na, in collaboration with other international organizations, FAO and WHO, with regional organizations, community, continue supporting veterinary alternatives. Veterinary means veterinary doctors are there, you may all be knowing. So veterinary doctors, they have some medication and all, they generally prescribe, just the human beings ki tarah alag alag medicines nahi hai, they have a common medicines for animal. And animals, because generally if you see the animals immunity and all is quite strong, hai na, if you see animals they are very robust and they just na kuch bhi wo jungle mein kuch bhi kha lete, fir bhi the diseases which are there, of course the disease attack is more because we are immunely not we are that strong, but we have medical care which is better, that's why we you know, the if you see the casualty figure in human beings is lesser than animals. The director general of the animal health office contact the secretariat of the United Nations International Strategy for interaction and all for animal health welfare, you know? So training, capacity building and all these sari cheeze mein hoti. So there are some more agencies which are involved. Of course, this is not an exhaustive list. Many other agencies, many other organizations are also involved, but just some organizations which are listed here, so you can comprehend their work. So there is the Doctors Without Borders Foundation, that is Medicine Sans Frontiers, an organization that is dedicated to helping people worldwide where the need is greatest, delivering emergency medical aid to people affected by conflict, epidemics, disasters or exclusion from healthcare. So these Doctors Without Borders means they are not restricted to one particular city, one particular state, one particular country. Samajh rahe ho? So they can travel to various parts of the country where people are affected and where the need is required. Then there is Mennonite Central Committee, is a global non-profit. All these organizations, mostly are global, some are local organization, but again they also work in the global context also. So Mennonite Central Committee is a global non-profit organization that strives to share relief, development and peace. When corresponding to disasters, when responding to disasters, they work with local groups and distribute resources in ways that minimize conflict. तो ये समझौता करने का काम भी करते हैं मेनोइट सेंट्रल कमिटी. डायरेक्ट रिलीफ इंटरनेशनल. डायरेक्ट रिलीफ इंटरनेशनल इज ह्यूमैनिटेरियन एड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. इट इज एक्टिव इन ऑल यूनाइटेड ऑल स्टेट्स ऑफ यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स ऑफ अमेरिका एंड 70 कंट्रीज एंड हैज अ मिशन टू इंप्रूव द हेल्थ एंड लाइव्स ऑफ पीपल अफेक्टेड बाय पॉवर्टी एंड इमरजेंसी. देन योर ब्रदरन डिजास्टर मिनिस्ट्रीज. So again, they are working in the repair and building of damaged houses and all. Then Ananda Marga, Amrut, which is called in short, Amrut Universal Relief Team. Its mission is to improve the quality of life for poor and disadvantaged people in the world besides those affected by calamities and conflict. Then we have REACT International. Of course, after COVID-19, many other agencies have come up internationally. So this list you will not find in this presentation, but you can find through net. Many other agencies after this advent of COVID and all, they have come for humanitarian aid. Also in local bodies and at the in national and district level, also in your local context also you can find many you can say NGOs which are working towards the relief and rehabilitation of people. So REACT International, they will provide public safety communications to individuals, organizations and government agencies to save lives, prevent injuries and give assistance wherever and whenever needed. All Hands is the world's leading disaster relief organization for all volunteers. So over the last 10 years, you can see they have enabled over 35,000 volunteers to donate 175 days impacting people. And itne logo ko maine help kiya with blood and with all other type of helps. City Term International Disaster Team. It is a Christian non-profit organization that compassionately serves the poor, homeless and lost in the तो ये सैन फ्रांसिस्को में प्राइमरीली दे वर डेवलप है ना, यहाँ पे उनका सही है. तो दे हेल्प द अदर पार्ट्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड आल्सो वेयर एवर द दिस. सो ऑक्सो मेनी मेनी यू कैन सी एजेंसीज व्हिच आर देयर व्हिच आर कनेक्टेड टू द चर्च और अदर रिलीजियस सेंटर्स एंड ऑल व्हिच आर हेल्पिंग. सो ऑक्सफैम इज अ इंटरनेशनल कॉन्फेडरेशन ऑफ 18 एनजीओस वर्किंग टुगेदर इन ओवर 90 कंट्रीज. दे हेल्प दोज हु नीड इट मोस्ट आफ्टर नेचुरल डिजास्टर्स लाइक देयर होम्स. Then we have again the Gates Foundation, Billy Graham. No, this is different. Billy Graham Rapid Response Team. Billy Graham Rapid Response Team trains the God's people. That means the machineries and you can see the people connected with the church and all. They create people for grief ministry. It also deploys crisis-trained chaplains to provide emotional and spiritual care to those affected by man-made or natural disasters. Then here ADRA, which is in Canada. So ADRA Canada, part of World Bank ADRA network, has been working to end extreme poverty in part of the poorest countries of our world for last 3 decades, like in the African continent and all. Many poor countries are there, so they are working for them. Then we have Hope Worldwide is an international charity that changes the dedicated staff that has dedicated staff and volunteers to deliver sustainable high impact community based services to the poor and needy. Then we have NACEMA. It is a voluntary organization that provides natural disaster preparedness, response, recovery services nationwide. Then you have again United Methodist Community of Relief. United Methodist Community of Relief is a non-profit organization dedicated to alleviating human suffering around the globe. In India, we have Plan India. Is a member of Plan International Federation, child development organization committed to create a lasting impact in the life of vulnerable and excluded children, their families and communities. So Plan India is there. Save the Children, again, 2005, Save the Children responded to, this is the 2005 figure, 15 figure, responded to 99 humanitarian crises in 59 countries, directly reaching so many people and so many children. CARE is there. CARE International is a global conference of 14 members. So you can see so many organizations are there. Global giving is there. Bill and Melinda. This is the Gates Foundation. So Bill Gates has promised 90 or 95% of their, you can say 90 or 97. I'm not remembering the exact figure, but that sort of their, you can say their stake, they are promised towards the foundation. ICO is their Interchurch Organization for Development Corporation. So they work towards a world in which people can live in dignity and well-being. In India also, Tatas have done an excellent job in providing relief, and Reliance and all is now coming up with different measures. Relief International is there. Relief International is a non-profit organization whose sole mission is to reduce human suffering. Mission Aviation Fellowship is there. So they reach their planes and all, they reach, you know, using their aeroplanes and using flight, they provide quick relief. World Vision is there. IMRF is there. They're committing to providing improving health of life in Africa and all. Shelter Box is there. You know, they provide emergency shelter and tools for families robbed of their homes by disaster. You know, kuch chori ho gaya, there is, you know, some sort of, you can say, burgling and all is there. So they provide some temporary or you can say relief tools and all for families. Medical Teams International provide medical and dental care, humanitarian aid, holistic development programs to all people in need. So regardless of religion, sex, nationality, race, they provide their help. Then Humanitarian Coalition is there to maximize Canadian. So that is based in Canada, but they have all over the work, all over the globe. Global Medic is there. So they respond to disaster, rescue unit, water purification, emergency medical services. Engineers Without Borders, this organization is there. Non-profit humanitarian organization established to partner with developing countries worldwide to improve the qualities of life. So these all things are there. So what we'll do tomorrow, we'll discuss the SPEAR project. All of you just give your attendance. Now receive the link.
No, sir.
Okay, just a moment. I'll send in the your this. I'm not sure there's a problem with the Google Meet. Messages are not going from my end. It's posting it, but they are not going. I'll send on your group. Fine?
Yes, sir. Can we leave?
Just a moment. I'll just try once more. Just a moment. I'll try to paste here once more.